I lit the scented shavings. A sweet aroma started to fill the room. I rested the side mirror precariously on the candelabra. I secured the mirror in place with some yarn. I lit the candles on the candelabra. Now that was something. The light from the candelabra spilled over the black Madonna like waves of spiritual goodness in candle form.
Pumpkin? Oh my!
What?
The sound of angels, the lights of heaven, the smell of piety, and...
Yes?
The Madonna, I do believe. Tears! She's crying, Dwayne! The Madonna's crying! Wrong side, little Timmy. Wrong side of the road. Not my fault. The broken leg. Compensation claim. Forgive me, poor Timmy.
Oh, Pearl, my precious, you're such a sensitive soul.
Well, now that's done. I feel my soul's floating on air. We can get on with our pilgrimage, Dwayne.
Just another 1,000 clicks to go.
Pearl was back to her usual cheery self.
Mrs. Henderson!
George, dear boy.
How you feeling?
Oh, just fine, thank you. I have just seen a miracle, George. It's all gonna be all right from now.
I'm sure it is, Mrs. Henderson, I'm sure it is. So, Pearl, what have you been up to since we last met?
Well, George, I've been on a journey.
Oh, really? Well, what kind of journey?
A spiritual one. A journey along the road to enlightenment.
Wow. And is that what brought you here?
It is. Though Santa Cova is but one step on that road.
What's so special about Santa Cova?
It's an ancient and very holy place. I've spent the last year researching it, and I can truly say there is nothing I do not know about it.
I don't suppose you'd know anything about that rock out there?
No, only that for 1,000 years, people have claimed to see a face in its shapes.
Still, keeping busy, Dwayne?
Like the man said, George, that old kaleidoscope keeps getting shaken, and the pieces are ever in flux.
Guess it's your job to pick them up, huh?
Well, somebody has to do it, compadre.
I enjoyed talking to Dwayne, but I was rarely any the wiser afterwards. Hey, have a look at this.
Don't you bring that thing anywhere near me, honey.
His name is Trevor.
You gave that a name?
He's a loyal and useful companion.
So is Dwayne, but I don't keep him in a box, George.
Well, there was that one time, honey.
Not now, Dwayne.
Pearl, does this mean anything to you?
Oh, nothing, dear. Apart from the obvious Gnostic connotations, of course.
What?
You know. The Dominicans, all those Gnostic saints, Doubting Thomas, Judas. And you see the woman in the red cloak? The infamous Mary Magdalene herself.
A lady in red.
That's enough now, Duane. You know my feelings about her.
Pearl knew her Gnostic onions, all right.
Then there's the Ouroboros, of course.
Something special about it?
Well, if I remember rightly, there was an Ouroboros right here in this chapel. Back in the 30s and 40s, the chapel was renovated. The workmen uncovered numerous symbols carved in the rock. Amongst them was a fine Ouroboros.
But that's amazing. So, where is it?
Oh, it's not there now.
Oh.
It was considered blasphemous, so they plastered over it. Sweetheart, I think it's time for us to go. The road to enlightenment waits for no woman.
'Tis the pilgrim's lot, George.
It was so nice to see you again. And meet your girlfriend.
Will not?
Take this radio, Nico. Never know when you might need it. Keep an eye on our boy George here.
Poor little lost lamb.
I'm not...
Don't worry, this little lamb's in safe hands. Bon voyage.
Bye-bye, dears.
See ya.
Nico, don't even start.
Little lamb?
Let's focus on the task in hand, shall we? Okay. This Ouroboros that Pearl mentioned.
You're right. We need to find it.
A modern plaster altar had been built against the rock. I hoped this was the right thing to do. Hey, Nico, I found the Ouroboros.
So what now?
Pearl was right. The plaster had covered an Ouroboros. I pushed the Ouroboros, but nothing happened. I pulled the Ouroboros, but it wouldn't budge. I pushed the Ouroboros, but nothing happened. There was a recess in the wall with a Latin word carved above it. Puritas, purity. I'd seen that word before somewhere. What was that noise? Another secret passageway.
Amazing, Charles. How did you do it?
Just another case of the old Stobart magic, I guess, Nico. It looks a little dark in there.
Are you scared, Charles?
Course not. Just worried about you tripping, that's all.